I didn't know there was a Gen Y. Did you know there was a Gen Y?
No.
Kailan lang heard of that?
X lang lahat eh.
X lang lahat. Okay. Anyway, to our guests naman, I will go to our guests. How do you choose your wardrobe? Lalo kayo mga artista. Pero anong in at saka anong baduy sa inyo? Pag umibili kayo ng
baduy.
Meron bang difference yung sinusuot ninyo in real life tsaka yung sinusuot nyo for television?
Yes.
Hold on. I will get back to you later. I will join muna our guests there. Excuse me. Okay, ano yun? Pag artista, pag sa TV, kailangan colorful. There was a time kailangan colorful. Ngayon, hindi na masyado.
And I think kailangan simple. Mm. Has to be simple.
On TV?
Yes, basic colors. Because first and foremost, kapag sa TV, if we have those really thin stripes, sumasayaw. So, yung things like that, the small things like that, you have
solid
to avoid.
Colors.
Yeah, solid colors, simple designs,
ayun.
Simple cuts.
Pero in real life, when you're not working, Mylene?
Me, it's just basically my jeans, my sneakers, and my white t-shirt. That's it. Always.
Ayun, jeans person din ako But, comfortable. Because
of comfort.
Because also, it's very warm in Manila. Si Jolina's known as a trendsetter. Where do you get your fashion ideas? Because they're really unique. But they're accepted. They're very sikat.
Sa akin kasi kinukuha ko minsan sa magazines, pero hindi ko eksakto ginagaya doon. Parang, kumbaga, na-execute ko pa nung yung sinasabi lang touch ng Jolina, parang ganun. And kaya siya nagkakaroon ng, kumbaga, sige, magdala kayo ng costume na parang Jolina. Kaya nagkaroon ng ganun, na
alam
nila. Ng trendsetter.
Ano pa yung look na Jolina?
Kasi ako, nagdadamit ako to satisfy myself. Hindi ko alam na nag-trendset na pala ako.
Pero anong look yun? Mas colorful?
Kasi ako, sa akin, nilalabas ko yung projection ko, nilalabas ko yung mood ko sa pananamit. Ngayon, medyo ngarag na ako, kaya nakaitim ako. Yun. Kaya, minsan pag makulay na makulay, huwag sabihin masayang-masaya talaga ako.
Ayun. So, si Tim, I'll go to Tim naman, nasa panel natin. Do kids nowadays, or the Gen X, Gen Y generation, do they have more money to spend?
Well, a lot of kids right now have credit card extensions, that's true. And
really?
A lot of them are, a lot. Casey, does Casey have a credit card extension?
Not.
Oh, there, she doesn't have. But a lot of kids have credit card extensions. A lot of kids are very independent. They work hard for their money. A lot of our young actors and actresses now work for their own keep.
Yeah.
Also, Sharon, I'd like to... We were talking, Claire and I were talking about that Gen X theme. Because a lot of young people nowadays don't want to be tagged as such as I'm a Gen X or I'm a Gen Y.
Right.
They just want to be tagged as, you know, this generation. Ito kami ngayon. Walang tag.
No,
you know,
I think,
no boundaries.
I think they gave you guys a label of either Gen X or Gen Y. It's only to kind of identify
the age
group we're talking about. So, okay yon. Tama, so you don't like to be labeled as such. For this generation, how important is education, Rico?
Well, first and foremost, we have to consider that for education to be effective, there has to be focus. Right now, kasi with Generation X, there are a lot of external factors that really influence their lives. Primarily TV. Media predominantly is a big factor in influencing a person's life. So, napakalaki ng influence nila, not only media, even peer pressure, even like the internet. Laking influence. So, nawawala yung focus sa education. They tend to veer away from education.
Kasi nung araw laruan namin basta Barbie, okay ka na.
Yeah. Diba? So, and kahit paano, before kasi may focus pa rin. Even though may mga laruan-laruan, you can still focus on school. On studies, but now it's very, very hard.
One question lang, what about religion? What about, is this a prayerful generation? Your faith in God strong, Maya? Ikaw?
Well, actually, I think there's it's in connection with the spirituality, because teenagers are discovering, they're exploring, they want to try unconventional ways of spirituality.
What about those values you grew up with, your faith and all?
Well, I think if you're rooted in that, because if you're rooted in that and your family influence is very strong, I think that won't really be a problem. But I think there's really a part of youth that wants to try something different. And, well, I saw
it's
something...
still a prayerful generation.
You still find
prayerful. Faith is still strong. Does everybody agree?
Yeah, faith is strong.
Yeah?
I think this generation, because it straddles two realms, kumbaga...
They want to have their cake and eat it
they're
too.
They're torn between being traditional. Kasi traditional, Pinoy pa rin eh. Mm. We're traditional. At the same time, we're also a very superstitious people. At the same time, yun nga, you want to explore, you want to try new things, ganon.
So, ay, it's
scary.
It's scary.
Very scary.
That's why really delving into occultism is something for me evil. In my opinion, there's nothing more genuine than the good book.
Yep. Also, well, this generation doesn't, if there's anything that this generation doesn't want to be, they don't want to be boxed.
Okay. So
sometimes, sometimes religion tends to box people. You know, it depends. If you have a good faith, good strong values foundation, it's liberating.
No, but baka some traditional traditional ways of worship and all. Pero baka yung mga ano pa, yung nakaset pa rin, di ba? It doesn't mean naman you have to be boxed, di ba? Yes. You can still express yourself and still follow whatever's still good and right. Anyway, we will come back to ang nakakaano, ang dami ko na di-discover, mga kaibigan. Ginagawa po kaya nila ang mga bagay na ito dahil lang daw sa itong in? At dahil pa rin sa tinatawag na peer pressure sometimes, malalaman po natin when Sharon returns. Wild things.